Hello and welcome to this tutorial on how to use the Digital Pali Reader. Previously we looked at how to install it. Now I'm just going to go through some of the menu options. So beginning with this first screen, which is the navigation. Here we can use these various options to bring up any particular text from the Tipitaka. Now some people might recognize the structure here, but others may not. So if we just look very quickly at the structure of the Tipitaka. So as most people know, it's split into three baskets, which is the Vinaya, the Sutras, and the Abhidhamma. And then each one of these, again, I'm going to mainly focus now on the Sutras because I think that's most important. The suttas are split down into the five Nikayas, and perhaps unusually, after that, the Digital Pali Reader splits it down into Vargas, which some people call chapters, but here it's listed as books. So we can see here in the sets we've got the Vinaya, we've got the five Nikayas, and the Abhidhamma. And below that we've got some others like the path of purification there. Anyway, so we'll concentrate on these. So the long Nikaya is split into three books. And this is also very similar to the Sutra Central. This is another great website which I recommend people use. Here they've got their three baskets again, slightly different order. But if we look at the sutras, we can see here the long, the middle, the linked, and the numbered, and that corresponds to these are just the Pali names of those ones. So the long, the middle, the linked, and the numbered. And if we go into the long, you can see here we want the digna here, which is, these are just giving you different language options. So if we open the Pali one, so here we can see the three Vargas which correspond to these three books. Now if you're looking at a sort of normal numbering scheme, this would be DN 1 to 13, and the second book is DN 14 to 23, and the third book is DN 24 to 34. So you can see how that works, but if you've just got the sutra reference as a DN14, let's say, you might have to play around a bit to find it. So here we can see that in the first Varga we've got DN1, DN2, etc. DN3, so those are, that's Sutra Central. We'll might do a separate video on that at some point. And also, if you go to Russell Webb's analysis of the Pali canon, he also breaks it down into here. You can see the Nikayas, and we'll just jump to that one. And then he breaks it down by the three Vargas. So you can see the actual names of the sutras and the reference numbers in that document if you want more information. So once we've selected, let's go to the second book, let's say, for instance. You can see here that the hierarchy changes. You can go, if you press this three lines here, you'll get the whole Varga, so the whole collection of 10 DNs there. And here you can see the sutras are broken down. Unfortunately, these aren't by the normal numbering reference schemes. It'd be nice if these were listed from 14 to 24, but they're not. And again, if we choose one, if we hit these three lines, it will bring up the whole DN sutra, but we can also break it down by subsections. So each sutra has subsections to it, so we can bring it up by subsections there. But let's go and hit that one. And there we go. So here it's DN15 that I've selected, which is the second sutra of the second book, so that makes sense. And you can see all the Pali is listed in here. If you get bored of that type of navigating, you can actually go in the quick links here and type in a normal reference number like DN10 and go and search for it. And there you go, it brings up DN10. You can see here the point one is the subsection that we were looking at. But unfortunately, if you do that, it doesn't update the book hierarchy underneath here, so just be careful of that. Now, this is all underneath what's called the moolas, the roots. Now, the Atikata, these are the commentaries, so people like Buddha Goza did a commentary for every single book of the Sutrapitaka, and you can see the names of the various sections here. So if you press the A here, you get all these books as well. So we start with book one. You can see all the different sections there. So you can actually then pull up Buddha Goza's version or commentary on that. And the T stands for tikas, and that's the commentaries on the commentary. So these are called the sub-commentaries. And you can go and search through that as well. So yeah, that's the basic way to navigate around the Digital Pali Reader.